Hi, I'm Mike from the YouTube desktop team, and I'm going to talk about how WebP helps to make YouTube faster. You may not realize it, but YouTube is one of the largest image hosting websites, serving tens of billions of video thumbnails every day. On many pages of YouTube, thumbnails can contribute up to 80% of total size. In fact, a typical page can easily contain more than a megabyte of image data. All those thumbnails add up. Client-side techniques like lazy image loading helps us to optimize rendering time, save bandwidth, and mitigate extensive backend load. But until recently, we had no way to significantly optimize the images by themselves. Fortunately for us, it turned out that another team at Google has been working on the WebP image format that delivers a significant improvement in image size, up to 30%, while maintaining the same quality, so we decided to give it a try. By the time WebP wasn't a complete stranger to us, as we already used it for image sprites, but all the data we had was relevant only to lossless compression. So, earlier this year, we ran an experiment to encode a fraction of video thumbnails hosted at YouTube in lossy WebP. We aimed to measure the bandwidth savings and confirm that WebP helps to improve rendering time of web pages. Knowing about the benefits of WebP, we still had to consider that introducing a new image format is not free. At a minimum, it meant that we had to store multiple variants of the thumbnail, WebP version for clients like Chrome or Android, and JPEG for all others. In addition, we had to remember that on the client, WebP does cost a little bit more to decode. So we wanted to see if the benefits outweighed the cost. This experiment displayed an average savings of over 20% of transferred bytes and up to 10% improvement in page rendering time, which translates to a huge improvement in overall user experience. Not to mention that on the mobile clients, like our Android application, bandwidth savings were particularly helpful as images are a significant contributor to data usage, even compared to video. So we've got a lot of great feedback from the users experiencing a smoother and faster UI. Based on these results, we decided to start encoding new thumbnails in WebP along with JPEG, and as a result, WebP currently contributes to over 10% of all YouTube image traffic, saving terabytes of bandwidth every day, and we expect it to become as popular as JPEG in near future, especially as we enable it on our iOS client, TV and console clients, and allow third parties to use it too. We're very happy with WebP at YouTube, and I encourage you to consider it for your site as well. Check out the WebP homepage to learn about the format and on how to get started. Thank you.